And welcome to another edition of our Faith Over Fear series. Okay, it's finally here, the month of February. Do you know what's so significant about the month of February? That's right, it's Black History Month, a time that the whole country can stop and recognize all of the many, many accomplishments that African Americans have made to this country. Dr. Carter G. Woodson, from the neighboring county of Buckingham, was the founder of this great celebration. Actually, when Dr. Woodson established this recognition, it was called Negro History Week. I'm glad this time has been set aside to recognize our many accomplishments, but I really wish that it was not set aside as a separate time, but rather that it would be fully incorporated into the school curriculum and studied all year long. Maybe one day. Well, our lesson today is about a father and two sons. It is a story told to help us understand that no matter what we do, God will still love us. After we've had our opening song and prayer, let's take a look at this story called The Prodigal Son.
Well, hey, everybody. Welcome to Mr. Harold's Music Class. February is Black History Month, but really, we celebrate Black History every day. So let's sing a little song about it.
Black History is the story of you and me. Black history goes way back for centuries. Black history did not start with slavery. Black History 365, not just February.
That's it. Now let's put a little sauce on it. Are you ready? 'Cause here we go. Our story begins in Africa, where the very first humans that lived are from. Along the Nile, big civilizations like Egypt and Kush and Nubia. We already know about the pyramids, built by blacks, not aliens. The African empires were glorious for their knowledge in science and medicine. Studied the stars, astronomy, made the calendar in 4000 BC. Math, religion, philosophy, Europeans came to study. Asked the Greeks, so many pharaohs, kings and dynasties. Even women were rulers, treated equally. Look around, 'cause we're all brothers and sisters, 'cause we all have an African ancestor.
Black history is the story of you and me. Black history goes way back for centuries. Black history did not start with slavery. Black history 365, not just February.
Here in America, history books only mention blacks as slaves after the 1600s. But there's more to the story. There were many black people in America before the Spanish and European conquerors. The Mali Empire sailed the Atlantic, went to Mexico to trade with the Mayans, brought back corn to the African lands. Do your research and you'll understand. Thousands of black folks sailed the seas to discover new lands on epic journeys. Fast forward to the 1700s when the colonies fought for the independence from the UK. Remember Paul Revere? Rode on a horse that the British are here. Well, there was a black guy riding on the side, Wentworth Cheswell. He rode through the night. There were even black politicians, Joseph Rainey in the House of Representatives.
Black history is the story of you and me. Black history goes way back for centuries. Black history did not start with slavery. Black History 365, not just February.
Black history is everyone's history. Make sure you walk up to a black person and say, thank you. Thanks for joining us on this sing-along in Mr. Harold's Music Class. Until next time, peace, love, and shabam!
Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to Faith Over Fear. Join me in a word of prayer. Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for my family. Thank you for my friends, Lord. Thank you for the teachers who provide this lesson for us. Lord, as we go throughout this day, Let us continue to be thankful for all the things you sent our way, sunshine and rain. Thank you for loving fathers and mothers and family members. Lord, we ask all these things in your name. Amen.
Jesus once told a parable about a father and his two grown-up sons. The wise father knew that his younger son wasn't prepared for real life. You see, the son wanted to leave home, so he asked his father for his inheritance, a lot of money. The kind father was very rich and very generous, so he gave his son what he wanted. The son packed up his belongings, hopped on his horse, and went off into the world. His father loved him and was disappointed to see him go. He was concerned about what would happen to his son. His younger son was immature, wasteful, and not prepared to live responsibly. The father was right. The younger son had no concern for tomorrow and lived only for today. He had tons of money and went to do all the wild and crazy things that a foolish young man could dream of. Girls, drinking, parties. He thought it was great. Everyone wanted to be his friend, but that did not last long. It was not long until the son lost all his money. Suddenly, no one wanted to be his friend. He became an outcast in a foreign land. No money, no friends, and no food. The young son realized his foolishness. All that he had was gone. Then he did the only thing he could think of to try and find some work so he could eat. Oh, he found a job, all right. But it was the worst job imaginable. He fed pigs. In his culture, pigs were unclean. Just to touch them was considered wrong and defiling. The young man was so hungry that he even started thinking about eating the pig's food, but no one gave him any. Suddenly, a thought came to him. Why was he here? Lonely, hungry, and miserable? Why did he leave his father's house? I will go back, the son decided. Even if I have to feed the animals, I'd rather do it in my father's house. If my father is angry, so be it. I deserve it. I just need to come home. And so he did. Dirty and bedraggled, tired and worn, he journeyed back to his father's house. He was still far from home, but then he saw someone running towards him on the path. Who was this? Who could it be? It was his father. From far in the distance, his father had been waiting for him, looking for him, hoping for his son to come home. They embraced each other. Though the son didn't realize it, the father was eagerly waiting for his son to return. The son began to blurt out his well-planned apology. Father, I've sinned. I'm so unworthy. But his father interrupted with a merry laugh. Bring to my son the best clothes, the fancy ring, the fine shoes, and let's have a celebration. To celebrate his son's return, the whole household had a huge party, complete with feasting, dancing, music, and singing. Not everyone was happy about the son's return. The older brother, who had always been obedient and respectful, did not appreciate the party. He didn't realize the wealth and love that he lived with all along. Instead, he was upset that a sinner had been saved. In this story, Jesus was telling us that God is like the loving Father. He loves us, wants us, and will welcome us home no matter how bad we've been. His love for us is eternal.
So what did you think of our story? Well, actually, it was a parable, one of the many stories Jesus shared with the people in his day. He used parables to help people understand the deeper meaning of God's word. This is a great story because it helps us to understand the love of God. You see, God is not the kind of God who would turn his back on you, even when you have turned your back on him. He is a loving and forgiving God. The great lesson in this story is that as you live your lives now, and even when you grow up, you may do many things that are not pleasing to God. But you can ask God to forgive you That is, as long as you are sincere, he will forgive you and you can count on that. You may not get a new set of clothes and a party when you return back to God and when you ask God to forgive you, but you will get God's forgiveness, which will last forever, which is better than a party that will only last for a day. Now, we should not live our lives recklessly and do anything we want because God will forgive us, because he will forgive us only when we are truly sorry and plan not to do it again, whatever it was that we were doing. I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that God is a forgiving God. The other lesson we can learn is from the other brother. He was not happy at all when his brother returned after spending all his money. And now his father was giving him a party? No way. He was not pleased at all. Matter of fact, he was fired up. I think most of us would kind of feel the same way he did. But God wants us to be happy and celebrate when someone who was down and out is able to turn themselves around and come back home. Well, see, this could apply to people who had run away, people who were in prison, and even to people who are addicted to drugs and finally get clean. The Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 26, if one member suffers, all suffer together. If one member is honored, all rejoice together. So let's try to put our anger and jealousy away and rejoice for the other person, just as you would want everyone to do for you. This is a great parable that you can look back on and read it every time you find yourself in a position of feeling like the prodigal son or like the brother. Well, that's our story for today. And after our Black History highlight, let's check out our closing song. And until next time, remember how far we have come as a people, and with faith in God, how far we can go in the future.
The month of February is designated as Black History Month. In the United States, it is a time to honor the important role African Americans play in the story of our country. The idea began as a week-long celebration in 1926, organized by historian Carter G. Woodson and others. It coincides with the birthdays of Frederick Douglass, a brilliant orator who escaped slavery and spent the rest of his life working to stop it, and President Abraham Lincoln, who issued the Emancipation Proclamation during the Civil War, which led to the eventual end of slavery in the U.S. Others who fought to end slavery include famous women like Sojourner Truth and Harriet Tubman. Woodson's idea caught on, and soon schools and communities around the country began organizing celebrations, starting history clubs, and hosting events to learn more about Black history and culture. The civil rights movement in the 1960s sparked even greater interest in the many accomplishments of notable African Americans, who excelled in all areas of life despite obstacles and hardships, like scientist George Washington Carver, educator Mary McLeod Bethune, baseball great Jackie Robinson, entertainer Oprah Winfrey, and President Barack Obama. Black history is American history. Black History Month is a special time to focus on and learn more about Black culture and people of African descent who have made American life richer. How is Black History Month celebrated in your school or community?
For lesson plans, digital resources, and more teacher support materials, visit PBSKidsLearningMedia.org.
Two brothers, and one of them was greedy brothers. Two brothers, and one of them was greedy. He said, "Dad, I want my money." He was the prodigal son. The other good brother stayed on the farm to work. The other good brother stayed on the farm to work. Greedy brother spent his money. spent it on having fun and drinky, drinky, spent it. He spent it on having fun and drinky, drinky. He spent every shiny penny, penny. He was the prodigal son. The money was finished, and so he fed the piggy, piggy's money was finished, and so he fed the piggy, piggy's. He was broke and kinda stinky, stinky. He was the prodigal son. He went home to daddy to say I'm really sorry, sorry. Went home to daddy to say I'm really sorry, sorry. Dad said so, let's throw a party, party. He was the prodigal son. The brother who stayed home was feeling kinda grumpy, grumpy. Brother who stayed home was feeling kinda grumpy, grumpy. He said, Dad, you must be crazy, crazy. He was the prodigal son. Said Daddy to Sonny, we're gonna have a party, party, Daddy.